now to something that I think is truly an example of shoddy journalism. And it begins with this question. Did the mayor of Minneapolis really flash a gang sign on camera? You might think so if you had watched this newscast from ABC affiliate KSTP last week.
Law enforcement sources alerted us to a photo that has them fuming over the actions of Minneapolis Mayor Betsy Hodges.
They want to know why the mayor would take a picture with a convicted criminal while he and the mayor flash gang signs. 5 Eyewitness News reporter Jay Coles obtained that photo and explains why officers think the mayor has put the public and police at risk. It's a story you'll see only on 5.
It's a story you'll see only on 5 because, well, I'd argue it's not a story at all. But that did not stop the reporter. Here's part of his report.
This is a photo of Minneapolis Mayor Betsy Hodges arm in arm with a man flashing what law enforcement agencies tell us is a known gang sign for a Northside gang. Court records show the man with the mayor has several recent convictions, including 2 felonies for selling and possessing drugs and illegal possession of a gun. He is currently sentenced to 5 years in prison, but won't serve that time if he stays out of trouble for the next 3 years. Law enforcement sources tell us they found this photo on the man's Facebook page while they were doing investigative work. They say there's no evidence he belongs to a gang, but they say he has connections to gang members. A spokesperson concludes by saying, quote, she and the man in the photo are just pointing at one another, to which the head of the police union says,
she's been around long enough, she knows better.
John Delmonico is the president of the Minneapolis Police Federation.
When you have the mayor of a major city with a known criminal throwing up gang signs, that's terrible.
He says it crosses a line and puts police in a bad spot.
Is this something that could incite gang violence in the city? And for as critical as she can be with the cops, is she going to support gangs in the city or cops?
So here is the key part. They were just pointing at each other. And it's obvious when you look at this. This is video that shows the pair snapping a quick picture together, awkwardly posing together as they walk to the streets for a get out the vote campaign, which Coles only mentioned late in the piece. Now here's the man in the photo, Neville Gordon, on that day.
I promise you, we want you to get out and vote. Get more people in your community involved.
Why do you come out to get out the vote?
I made some mistakes in life, you know. I can't vote, I'm not ashamed to say that, but I'm working on fixing that right now so I can be able to vote for my next president.
So a couple things here. Gordon does have a criminal record, but says he's not in a gang and that the two were just pointing. And here's what this story is really about. The mayor and the police in that city seem to be at war, and it's been true for a while. The mayor says she thinks the head of the police union is trying to discredit her reforms. Now, KSTP is not backing down. They say they spent days properly vetting the story and accurately reported what they were being told by the police. Now, this has become known on the web as Pointergate. Look at these pointing parodies. One Twitter user wrote, A2 Dalai Lama. And then you keep going here. This one shows a picture of Vice President Biden with the caption, Nighty Night Gangstas. And another one writes, just look at these two thugs flashing gang signs at each other. This was the start of all our problems. But all laughs aside, what happened here is serious. It's about reporting and also about race. And I have 2 CNN contributors here to analyze it all. Errol Lewis is the host on New York One and the director of the Urban Reporting Program at the City University of New York's Journalism School. And Mark Lamont Hill is a host on HuffPost Live and a professor of African American Studies at Morehouse College. And the three of us are sitting here watching these clips and, you know, I don't even know where to start, Errol. You work in a local TV station newsroom. How do you think this happened?
Well, I think part of what happens is people get a story in their head, and if they're going to be lazy about it, and, you know, laziness is basically a species of unprofessional behavior, you just go ahead and run with it. Take your source and say, well, it's an official source. The police are,
right.
You know, and so we'll just
report. We're just going to report what they told us.
We'll report the controversy. And, you know, they just couldn't have been more wrong. I mean, off camera, by the way, if you do a little bit more reporting on it, the police chief was standing next to the mayor. The police chief and the mayor there with this guy, Neville Gordon. I thought this was comedy, frankly. I thought this was a Dave Chappelle skit,
comedy,
you know, come back to life.
But, yeah. Mark, is this also deliberate, you think?
I don't know if it's deliberate. I mean, I think that's part of the problem is that when we look at race and racism in media, we often reduce it to the level of intentionality, whether or not they meant to misrepresent something or they meant to tell the wrong story. That's not the point. The point is that it was so easy to believe this story. The fact is, as Errol said, that they wouldn't even feel the need to investigate a story like this speaks to the problem as well. And this isn't the first time this happened. In Ferguson, when they brought in the black officer to help reduce some of the tension, he threw up his fraternity sign. And they said he was posing with gang signs. So, and that was a few months ago. You'd think we'd learn from that mistake. But instead, no matter who you are, no matter how you're framed, there's still this tendency to find the lowest common denominator when we speak about certain types of people in the media.
And then the station has doubled down, tripled down, defended itself for days afterwards. I wonder if that's actually the even worse sin.
That is the worst sin, I think, because, you know, anybody can get a story wrong. You can get spun. Your source takes you in a different direction. Maybe you didn't get it right, you know. But the trust with the viewers is broken when you don't, when confronted with an obvious problem, an obvious flaw, sort of go re-examine it, go from scratch, apologize, just say, look, it's a busy newsroom, we got it wrong, we're not afraid to say it, all that matters to us is the truth. Something other than the truth is their primary consideration in that newsroom, and that is the problem.
Anyway, yeah. Mark Lamont Hill, Errol Lewis, thank you for breaking it down for us and explaining
You're
what
welcome.
Went wrong. Yes, to you too.